I want to thank the sponsor for her answers. I want to point out that I think there is much gray area in this bill, including the definition of an employer and whether it must.
Senator Krueger on the bill.
Thank you, Mr. President. There's much gray area, including who is defined as an employee of a company that has to follow New York State employment law. There's confusion still for me about whether this actually implements the same standards and requirements for employees of the legislature and the executive. There's no clarification of who they would demand an investigation from and how that would be conducted. I do not see language that broadens, as I feel it should, the categories where you can bring a case, because if you limit the definition of sexual harassment, you find yourself in any number of situations where what happened to you may not be defined within this definition of sexual harassment. And actually, the senator and I went back and forth on that when we did the One House Senate bill. And I don't think we've clarified it or cleared it up in this bill. It's also not clear to me, and according to a number of employment law specialists, it's not clear to them that this doesn't, perhaps unintentionally, weaken protections people have had when they bring cases in court for years in the courts of New York State. And again, I am concerned if I have experts in the field of protecting people in these situations telling me that perhaps unintentionally they believe that we are actually weakening the rights and protections that people have already had in New York State. I know, just like Senator Young knows, that we need to fix these problems. We are in total agreement on that. I just don't know that we have accomplished the goals in the context of this set of bill sections within the health budget bill. Concerns, and I'm not going to go through all of them, about tracking contractor data, tracking the obligations of the independent contractors with four contractors, tracking how there will be reporting and enforcement by the two agencies who are mandated to play a role here. There are all kinds of issues within the employment law world about vicarious liability questions, and I won't even pretend to ask questions on vicarious liability because it's just another place where I forgot to go to law school and I wouldn't do justice to their issues. I am concerned that we are missing important sections when we look at this, including clear and strong definition of sexual harassment as just one form of discrimination, the importance of being explicit in our definitions so that we strengthen the rights and remedies available to victims, the importance of non-retaliatory law so that people who come forward as whistleblowers or confirmers of what they have seen do not face the loss of their own job and status simply for standing up for other people that they have seen being the victims. It was a try. I'm going to even say it was a really good try, but I think we missed the boat. Is that the right analogy? You miss the boat or the train? I'm from New York. You miss the subway on whether we actually got there enough that we can say to people in the state of New York, no, no, we took care of all this. We passed this law within our budget. I wish that we had had public hearings. I wish that we all had an opportunity to hear from the employment law specialists, explain the concerns about vicarious liability and actually the possibility that we've decreased people's rights and protections. I wish we had a situation where victims actually felt comfortable coming forward to tell us why it doesn't work now and why they're concerned that it won't work under this either. It's true that maybe we can try to fix it after we see that we didn't get far enough. I just wish we had gotten farther here today. Thank you, Mr. President.